Hi, Mike Austin here again for FluidPowerJobs.com. This is our little get-together where we get to talk about the fluid power industry. We give you some tips, some tricks, some things that you need to do to land that job and to get that interview. Always remember, you can visit us on the web at FluidPowerJobs.com. So let's talk today about interviews a little bit. We hate them. We all hate them. Here's some good news. The interviewer hates them too. You're under a little bit of stress. They're under a little bit of stress to fill that job. They would like you to be the one that fills that job. So do yourself a favor and relax, okay? Put yourself at ease, and I'm going to give you some ways to do that. Again, a lot more tips at FluidPowerJobs.com. Number one, the interview is not about you. Aha. It is about you filling the need of the employer. Something you should try to think about is put yourself in their position. Become the employer. Think about what it is that you need from you if you were them. The next point I'd like to make is for you to be enthusiastic. You are, of course, enthusiastic about trying to land a job. You may even be desperate. There's a difference between desperate and enthusiastic. Finally, I'd like to make a point of I've been accused a lot of talking too much. Don't do that. A friend of mine said, if I ever had to do an interview, I would talk myself out of the job. Give short answers and concise answers. And again, you can come up with that by the more you role play and rehearse and practice your answers and be confident in those answers. Give short answers, concise answers. And then, if the interviewer, your potential employer, would like to know more, they'll ask you for more. And give a little bit more, but leave them wanting some. Leave them wanting some for you to come back and fill in those gaps for them. But don't talk yourself out of the job, as my friend said. You can learn more about these tips and so many more. A lot of resources for you at FluidPowerJobs.com. FluidPowerJobs.com is your resource on the internet for connecting with employers and for employers to connect with you. I'm Mike Austin. Good luck. Now go get that interview. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, we'll do. All right. Great. Thank you for your time. Okay. Bye. We're all connected these days quite a bit, aren't we? Hi, Mike Austin here once again for FluidPowerJobs.com, your leading resource for professional career development in the fluid power industry. Talk a little bit about today about telephones and how connected we are, specifically a telephone interview. More and more interviewers are getting creative. There are Skype interviews now. There are video resumes and telephone interviews. Many times a potential employer would like to talk to you first over the phone and get a feel for what you're like and ask some preliminary questions before you walk in. So I'd like to give you a couple of tips on a telephone interview today. First and foremost, have a copy of your resume sitting right next to you on the kitchen table or your desk so that you can reference back to it if your potential employer asks you a question pertaining to your resume, or maybe you can even bring up something from your resume and sort of steer that conversation. Secondly, make sure you have a pad and a pencil or a pen, something that you can write with and on to take notes, and you can reference back to that and maybe write down a few questions that you have about this potential employer. My wife brought this one up to me. If you are a dad or a mom, make sure the kids are not anywhere within earshot during this telephone interview. Preferably, if mom or dad can take the kids to a park for an hour or so, or maybe grandma and grandpa can come and get them completely out of the house, because you do not want to sit them down in front of a videotape or something and have that end, and then now it's treat time. You just don't want that noise and that distraction. You're gonna find this information and a whole lot more over at our website, FluidPowerJobs.com, the leading career resource in the fluid power industry. I'm Mike Austin, now go get that job. Hi, Mike Austin again for FluidPowerJobs.com, the leading resource for professional career development in the fluid power industry. You can find us on the web, FluidPowerJobs.com, and a lot of great information about interviewing, finding your next career move, and fear. that is alleviating fear. Let me talk a little bit about that today, and you'll find more information on this at fluidpowerjobs.com. Fear is really the unknown, isn't it? If you know about something, if you know what to expect, whether it's a new job, a new career, a new town that you're moving to, a new position you're taking over, that fear is sort of alleviated. If you're going into an interview, the better prepared you are, the less fear you will have. We all fear change because it's sort of stepping off into that unknown. So let me give you a few tips on dealing with that. Number one would be know yourself. Know what you expect out of your new career, out of a new area you're moving to. And know your values. Does the area fit what it is you're about? If you're into the arts, is there enough of that? Are there plays? Are there museums in the area you're looking at moving to? What about the company you're going to go to? Do you value a lot of time with your family? Maybe you're a single person and you're into putting in way, you live at the company. Well, if that's important to you, of course they may enjoy that, your time at the company. But if you do value your time with your family, is this new company going to play into that? And will they value the same thing? Again, you can find more information on alleviating these fears at fluidpowerjobs.com on interviewing, finding your next career move, your next job, and moving on up. And alleviating those fears. Know yourself. Know your values, and find us on the web at fluidpowerjobs.com, the leading resource in the fluid power industry and developing your career. I'm Mike Austin. I'll see you next time. Another gray one. Hi, Mike Austin here one more time for fluidpowerjobs.com, the leading resource for career development in the fluid power industry. Maybe I shouldn't pull that out because I have fewer and fewer of them all the time as well. But it kind of speaks to what I want to talk to you about today, and that is changing a career or looking for a job when you're over 50, 50 and over. This is a challenging area because, boy, there are more and more and more 20-somethings coming out of universities and colleges, way more up to date on technologies and things like that that can sometimes be a challenge for someone who is 50 and over. Here's a few tips that you might want to consider. First of all, you have a lot more going for you than you think. When you are 50 years old or older, think about the sphere of influence you've had or the network that you've built over the years. And the people that you know in that network are way more connected and way more influential than someone generally, you know, younger than you. So use that network. Make sure you go to lunch with certain people maybe you haven't contacted for a while. Stay in contact through Facebook, email, a phone call every now and then. Also, make sure you treat your job search as a job. Get up the same time every morning. Get a routine going. Phone calls at a certain time. Resume working at a certain time. It's kind of like your job is to get a job. When you're 50 and older, a big thing to keep in mind also is your health. Don't let the stress of your job search and career change, trying to line up movers and all of that get to you. Make sure you eat right, plenty of rest, you all know it, lots of fluids and exercise. Take a walk every now and then and clear your head. You'll find these tips and a whole lot more over at our website, fluidpowerjobs.com, the leading resource for career development in the fluid power industry. You're 50 or older, you got a lot more going for you than you think. I'm Mike Austin, and go get that job. Hi, Mike Austin once again for fluidpowerjobs.com, the leading resource for the professional career development in the fluid power industry. Today, I want to talk a little bit about counter offers. You can find a lot of information at fluidpowerjobs.com, including more things on counter offers and what to do with them. So you found a company. Maybe they found you. They've heard about your work. They love you. You love them. They've flown you to wherever they are. You've been wined. You've been dined. You've been interviewed, and it's a match made in heaven. And so now you have an offer from this new company. You go back to your current employer, you say, you know what, I think I'm going to jump ship. Ah, but wait, says your boss, you're a valuable asset to our company. We need you. Tell you what, We'll match their offer and we'll give you X, Y, and Z, and everything will be blissful, right? Counter offers. At fluidpowerjobs.com, we have a whole list of why counter offers may not be what you think they are, and some reasons that you may consider saying no to your current employer's counter offer. Let's say they do give you a counter offer and you mull it over. Well, you're gonna from then on wonder, where was that money before? Where was this pat on the back before? And it could very well affect your relationship with your employer, your other co-workers, and your performance on that job psychologically. Where was all of this before? Secondly, you are now to your employer kind of a flight risk because they know that you've been looking. They know that you're looking out there, and they're always going to wonder, well, okay, he's back with us now, but maybe he or she is going to leave down the line, maybe in just a few months when they get another offer. And another reason is, you know, the reasons you were leaving the company in the first place most likely have not changed. One more thing I'd like to offer up to you is a statistic. And again, you'll find more tips on counter offers and what to do with them at our website, fluidpowerjobs.com. 85% of employees who have accepted a counter offer from their current employer generally leave either of their own accord or are asked to leave within the first year of accepting that counter offer. Counter offers may not be what you think they are, may not be what's right for you. Mull it over. Find our other tips and our whole entire article and section on counter offers at fluidpowerjobs.com, your source on the web for the fluid power industry and your next career move. I'm Mike Austin. I'll see you next time.